Hi, this is Electronics. This is the second part of the video in which I will try to repair the Wonky Monkey Rumble Bluetooth speaker. In the first video, I've disassembled and desoldered the main circuit. You can watch the video here or you can find the link in the description. I will use a TC4056A IC-based charging and protection circuit for the lithium-ion battery. Later I will have to do some modifications on the circuit in order to safely charge the small battery. The other circuit is the DWCT14+ Bluetooth receiver circuit. You can watch a review video of this module here or you can find the link in the description. First, I desolder the connectors from this module to save some space. I speed up the video while I desolder the parts. It's finished, you can see the pads on which later I can solder the wires. Next, I do some research in the TC4056A datasheet. The links for the datasheets are in the description. The charging current can be limited by changing the resistor value at the pin 2. On the original circuit, the resistor can be found with the label R3 and the value is 1200 ohm, which means it will charge with 1 amp. As you may know from the previous video, this Bluetooth speaker has a 400 mAh battery from factory. Charging of the lithium-ion battery should be done with less than half of the capacity of the battery, which means it should be less than 200 mA for this battery. According to this chart, if I use a 10k ohm resistor for the R3, then the charging current will be set to 130 mA, which is good for this small battery. Luckily, I found several 10k ohm SMD resistors on the original board, so I could use one from there. First, I desoldered the 1200 ohm resistor from the charging protection board. Then I desoldered the 10k ohm resistor from the original board and check it with the multimeter. The final step is to solder back the 10k ohm resistor to the charging board. I make a close-up shot so you can see it better. Next, I solder the negative wire of the battery to the charging board and test the charging while measuring the current with the multimeter. The charging is working. The decreasing value of current shows that the battery is getting charged. The charging board's shape has to be modified in order to fit in the bottom cover of the Bluetooth speaker. First, I clip down the corners and after that, using a file, I make the corners round. Using double-sided adhesive tape, I place the circuit and an on-off switch to the backplate. After that, using a hot glue gun, I fix permanently the components. This is the component connection scheme. According to this scheme, I've soldered together the components and tried to fit inside the Bluetooth speaker. To finish the project, I just put back the three screws and the rubber pads. Now you can see and hear the final result. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe and leave a like if you want to see more videos similar to this one.